50 watts when the temperature is 77 degrees of the cell itself. You feel it now. It's much hotter than 77 because it's warmer than my hand, and I know I'm at least 97.4. But so this is pretty hot. What happens with electricity when it gets hot, when it heats up, you get more resistance and the voltage drops. The pressure drops. The pressure is the voltage. Current is the flow of lead water. Current is the flow of watts of power. So this will produce 50 watts of power when the sun is 1,000 watts per square meter hitting it and the temperature is 77 degrees. Less sunlight, like crispy in a cloud or a cloudy day, you can get less flow of electrons, which you're going to have less power. So just because this is 50 watts, it's not making 50 watts 24 hours a day. Depending on your area, it might make an average of, you make 50 watts for, you pushed all the time during the day together, on average it might be in this area, it might produce 50 watts for 4 hours a day. This was all the time that you have. I don't want to dwell too much on how it works, but just so you get an idea that it's real important to, because I was over in Africa teaching some water pumping things, and they needed the pumps that they were being put in the ground required 2,000 watts of power. And the problem is, people thought, oh, then I'll put 2,000 watts of solar panels on. But like we're seeing, a 2,000 watt solar array is not going to produce 2,000 watts on a small time. So you have to know a lot more about the area you're in, location, where is the sun, how much, what is the temperature you're expecting. But it also can figure it out. So, yes.
So when the sun is from the cloud, how much solar is it?
When the sun comes in front or a cloud? It's mostly current.
So current is, when you put a meter on this, yeah, and shade it, you watch what pulls it.
Yeah.
The when you shade one of these, the good thing is you can take the inverters that we use to go to AC or run it through a charge controller. They take a lot of variable voltage from the input and the output. We want flat, steady to charge like the next over trailer and things of that nature. So it goes through a control device to flatten it out. So when you're asking like current voltage, there's a lot of spectrum in that graph that changes throughout the day. Early morning, I may see a little spike in this. There's just a lot that can change in that whole balance between current and voltage. Overall, the inverter and the charge controllers, they balance all that out. We probably heard